Hi, it's Dibyajyoti Mahapatra. Welcome to my channel, DJM Physics. Good morning, students. So in the last class, we have studied about the basic concepts of series and parallel connections. We have also solved some 1 to 2 questions to understand the formula. Now let us carry forward the same topic and we will solve some different kind of questions from series parallel connection of capacitors. Okay. So first let us understand how to detect whether it is a series connection or it is a parallel connection. The actual rule is that if in some case you are seeing that the charge is divided, like let there are 2 capacitors here, okay, they are connected like this and current is coming from here or charge is coming from here. So here there is a junction and the current has to be divided. So in such case you will know that it is a parallel connection. In series connection, how you will know that it is a series connection? Whenever the potential has to be divided, then you will know that it is a series connection. But many times this is the actual definition in which you can solve all the questions. But let me tell you a shortcut which may not be applicable in 100% of questions or in all the questions, but it will be applicable in 99% of the questions that you are going to face in your board exam or in your entrance exams. Okay, there are some exceptions, or they are not actually exceptions, they are some type of questions in which this formula cannot be used easily. Okay, so let me first tell what is that shortcut. If let there are 3 capacitors like this, or let there are 4 capacitors like this, okay, C1, C2, C3 and C4, okay, and here you can see that each plate, if I am leaving like this, means these 2 are connected with the battery. Okay, now you can see here that one plate of the first capacitor is connected with the battery and the second plate is connected with the one plate of the capacitor 2. Now just check these 2. For these 2 you can see one plate is connected with another plate of the second capacitor, but this plate cannot connected with this. So this is a series connection, means out of 2 plate, if one plate of the one capacitor is connected to one plate of the other capacitor, then it is known as a series connection. If both the plates of one capacitors are connected to both the plates of the another capacitor, then it is a parallel connection. For example, this is now a series connection. C1 and C2 are in series connection because only one plates are connected. But if I will keep a wire from here and I will put it here, or like this, if I will put a wire like this, now you can see, or you can understand, that C1 and C2 will be parallel connection because this plate is connected here and this plate is connected here. So both the plates are connected with both the plates. So now C1 and C2 are in parallel connection. Now let us check C2 and C3. Here you can see C2 one plate is connected with C3 one plate, and this plate cannot connected with this plate directly. Okay, so it is a series connection. Similarly with C3 and C4, you can see one plate is connected with one plate of C4, but this plate cannot connect with this plate. So again these 2 are in series connection. But if you put a wire like this, let I am putting a wire from here to here. Now you check between C2 and C3, this plate is connected with this plate and this plate is connected with this plate. So now again C2 and C3 are in parallel connection. Okay. Now if this is a final circuit, then you can see C1 and C2 are in parallel, C2 and C3 are in parallel. Now let us check C1 and C3. C1 you can see one plate is connected like this to this plate. So this plate and this plate are connected. Similarly from this plate is connected. So this plate of C1 is connected with one plate of C3 and the other plate of C1 is connected with the other plate of C3. So now I can tell C1 and C3 are also in parallel. So this connection I can draw a equivalent as C1, C2 and C3 are parallel to each other, means the diagram is going to be like this. C1, C2 and C3 are in parallel to each other and C4 is in series. So this is C1, C2, C3 and C4. Okay, if this is given in exam, then it's very easy for us to find out. But if this type of connections are given in exam, then also you have to check whether they are series and parallel, series or parallel. Your class 10 knowledge normally tells that if they are in line by line, then they are series. If they are in like step by step, then they are in parallel, like this. But it is not applicable every time. You can see here, just by looking, if you will see, they are in series, they are in line, but they are not in series due to these two way. Okay, now let me again tell you, if I will put another capacitor here, now you cannot tell that C1 and C2 are in parallel, because only one plate is connected here, the other plate and this plate cannot connect it directly. Okay, this plate is connected with this plate, not with this plate directly. So now C1 and C2 became in series, and again you will get a different equivalent circuit. Is it clear? So to draw an equivalent circuit, you have to check whether they are in series and parallel, and you can remember this method, which is actually a cheat method, it is not the exact method. This method is, if both the plates are connected with both the plates of other capacitor, then they are in parallel, otherwise they are in series. Okay, so this is one thing. Let me tell you another thing. It is important to find between which two points capacitance is asked. Okay, like if let there are four capacitors like this connected on a rectangular shape. Here there is one capacitor, here there is one capacitor, here there is one capacitor, and here there is one capacitor. There are four capacitors like this. Okay, let it is of 2 farad, it is of 3 farad, it is of let 6 farad, and it is let of 12 farad. Now if someone is asking, let me give the names also, A, B, C, and D. Now if someone is asking, what is the net capacitance between A and D? What is the equivalent capacitance between A and D? Okay. Now what is the equivalent capacitance between A and B? What is the equivalent capacitance between A and C? What is the equivalent capacitance between B and C? Like that, many questions can come. So first question is, what is the equivalent capacitance between let A and B? Okay. Here very important to understand that if it is asked between A and B, then the trick is draw a line connecting these two points A and B. Solve once from the opposite of the line, and okay, let us not start from here, let us start from these two so that it will be easier to understand. It is asked, what is the equivalent capacitance between A and C? So join a line, just an imaginary line you draw, and solve from this side separately and solve from that side separately. It means find the equivalent capacitance of these two. Now these two are connected in series because only one plate is connected here, this plate is not connected with this, so they are in series. So if they are in series, how much you will get between these two point along this side? In series means you will get C1 into C2 divided by C1 plus C2. Remember that formula. So 12 into 2 divided by 12 plus 2. So it will be how much? 24 by 14. Okay. This is the A point and this was the C point. Okay. Or now I can draw the C point here also, because I have taken all these two capacitor to one capacitor. I can draw it now like. Now between A and C point along this side, again 3 and 6 are in parallel, sorry, in series, because only one plate are connected. So 3 and 6 in parallel means they will give you 3 into 6 divided by 3 plus this, the shortcut I have told yesterday. So it is 18 divided by 9, or it is equal to 2. So here again you can draw a 2 farad capacitor. Now you can see between A and C, these two are in parallel. So simply what will the net one? Net one will be addition of these two, means 24 by 14 plus 2, that will give you the answer, that much farad. Okay, so here you are getting one answer. Now let us see what answer you will get if it is asked the net capacitance between A and D. Okay, between A and D. So now where your line should be? A line joining the two lines A and D. Now solve from this way. In this way come from A to D, and from this way come from A to D. So here there is only one capacitor. So let us draw it first. So here there is a point. Here it is 2 farad. Here there is a D point. And along this direction if you come, you can see that this and this, they are in series. Yes or no? This all the three are in series. So what will be the answer? If they are in series, it will be 1 by 3 plus 1 by 6 plus 1 by 12 inverse. Or you will get, if it is 12, it will be 4 plus 2 plus 1 inverse, or you will get 12 by 7 farad. So along this side, there will be 12 by 7 farad. Okay. Now if it is 12 by 7, now what will be the net cap, net actually? The net will be, now they are in parallel, so 2 plus 12 by 7. It will be 26 by 7 farad. You can see you are getting a different answer here. Here you are getting 28 plus 24, it is 52 divided by 40. Okay. So here you are getting a different answer. Here you are getting a different answer. Similarly, you can solve from what is the equivalent capacitance between A and B. If you are finding out from A to B, then these three will be in series and this will be in parallel with the equivalent of these three. Again, you will get a different answer. Okay. Similarly, from B and D, these two in series, these two in series, and this, the equivalent of these two, equivalent of these two are in parallel. So again, you will get a different answer. So it is important to check also between which two point the capacitance is asked. Okay. If you will not find that, because see, sometimes students, what they are going to do, between any point they are going to, they means if between any point if the question is asked, they are going to solve it in their own way. No, you will not get a correct answer. So it is very important to understand between which two point the capacitance is asked. Okay. I think these two points are clear. And in the last class, I have solved one question. The last question, if you have not checked that clearly, now also there is time, go and check that quickly and then come for the solution of the solution of the series parallel connection of capacitors. Now let us come to the numerical part and solve the first numerical. So this is our first question. Here there are three capacitors as shown in the figure. Draw the diagram in your copy and write down the question also. This is a 6 volt battery. This is C1 of 10 microfarad. This is C2 of 5 microfarad. And this is C3 of 5 microfarad. Question is, write down the question, calculate the charge and potential across each capacitor. Okay. Calculate the charge and potential across each capacitor. This is the question. So for this type of question, I have solved this type of question in the last class. So directly let me solve. Draw the equivalent circuits one after another. So the first equivalent will look like this. See, these two are in parallel because this end is connected here, this end is connected here. So these two are in parallel. So first find their capacitance. So here there is a 6 volt battery. Here there is a C1 that will be 10 microfarad. And here, let at this place I can draw, it will be 5 plus 5, let it is C4. That will be again equal to 10 microfarad and they are connected like this. So this is the first step. Okay, don't skip any step. As I have told in the last class again, Now next circuit diagram. Now these two are in series because only one plate is connected to each other. This plate is connected to battery, this plate is connected to battery. So these two are in series. Now if two cells are in series, then how much you will get? I have again given a shortcut in the last class that if they are same, okay, means if 10, 10, 10, 10, 4 capacitors are connected in series, then it will be 10 by 4. If 20, 20, 20 they are connected, then the net will be 20 by 3 in series, okay. Check the formula that I have given in the last class. So here 10 and 10, you can do in any way, 1 by 10 plus 1 by 10 inverse, or 10 into 10 divided by 10 plus 10, or simply 10 by 2, you will get 5. So the next equivalent capacitance, equivalent circuit will be like this. Here there is a 6 volt, here a capacitor of, let it is a C, or you can write it as C5 since it is the last one. I am simply writing it as C equal to 5 microfarad, and here they are connected with the battery. Okay, now solve from the last one. I have told this is my diagram 3, the diagram 2, diagram 1. I have to solve like this. So let me write the data of this diagram here, and this diagram here. Like that also you can do in your exam. So from this diagram, what are the data I can get? C is known, V is known. So what will be the value of Q? As we know, Q equal to C into V, or imply that Q here will be equal to C is 5 into 6. So 5 into 6 micro coulomb. Here there was a micro, so I have written a micro. So I can write Q equal to 30 micro coulomb. So this is one answer. This is the total charge actually. This is not asked, but you have to find it to find the other things. Now from here you have to solve from the next part, from this diagram. In this diagram you can see that these two were in series to give this capacitance. So obviously whatever charge is here, these two will get the same charge. Okay, so if this got a 30 micro coulomb charge, these two will also get 30 micro coulomb and 30 micro coulomb, okay, because they are in series. So I can write here Q1 equal to Q4, this one equal to Q equal to 30 micro coulomb. So here also I am getting an answer. What is that? Charge on this capacitor, see Q1, or charge on this capacitor. Now if Q1 is known and C1 is known, I can also find V1. So how to find V? V equal to what? Q by C. So V1 will be equal to Q1 by C1. So Q1 is here 30 micro coulomb divided by C1 is 10 microfarad. So they will give you 3 volt. So this is also one answer. V1 equal to 3 volt. Similarly, V4 I can find. V4 will be equal to Q4 divided by C4, or 30 micro coulomb divided by again 10 microfarad equal to 3 volt. So V4 I got. Or you can simply write like this. I have also given the shortcut that since they are same, okay, the potential will be divided among them equally, because I have told you that in series connection potential is divided, or V is inversely proportional to C. But here both are same, so obviously the 6 volt will be divided among themselves equally. So this will get 3 volt, this will get 3 volt. So like that also you can find, but this is the method. Or in exam you should write like this, in normally in board exam or in class exams. In entrance you can directly use the shortcut to write the exam. Now let us find the next one. From the first diagram, what are the known things? See, this part we have already done, because we have found V1, we have found Q1, so this capacitor we don't have to do anything. Now let us check for these two capacitors. These two capacitors were in parallel, so they are in parallel and giving this C4, okay. So it means whatever potential this one is having, remember potential not charge, because in parallel connection potential will remain same. So whatever potential this is having, the same potential these two will have. So what is the potential here? V4, that is 3 volt. So here I can write V4 will be equal to V2 will be equal to V3. Potential across this, and that will be equal to how much? 3 volt. So this is also one answer. V2 and V3 we found out. Now let us find charge. Very simple. C2 we know, V2 we know. How to find Q2? Q equal to C into V. So C2 into V2. So it is 5 microfarad into 3, or it will be equal to 15 microfarad. Similarly, you can find Q3. It will be C3 into V3, and C3 is 5 microfarad and V3 is 3 volt. So it will be 15 microfarad. So this is the answer of Q2 and this is the answer of Q3. So you can see you have got all the answers. What are the answers? V1, V2 and V3. All are actually 3 volt. And Q1, Q2 and Q3. Okay? And again, as I have told in the last class, don't add 3 volt, 3 volt, 3 volt, and sir, answer is coming 9 volt. How it is 6 volt here? I have explained that answer in the last class. If you have not seen, go and check it. So it is the exact same question as we have solved in the last class. Now let us come to the next question. So this is the next question, and the question is, in this circuit, find the capacitance between A and B, equivalent capacitance between A and B. First thing, let me tell you how students do the mistake. They are normally going to see these two are in series, these two are in series, and these two are in parallel, and they are accordingly doing that. No, don't ever do that. So how to do? If you want to find the capacitance between these two, first let us solve between these two points. If these three circuits, these three capacitors will not be there, and only one capacitor will be here, then you can see that it is a very simple circuit of three series capacitors. So first let us find the capacitance between these two points, equivalent capacitance between these two points. Forget about these two, and in this part, in this loop, first let us find the equivalent capacitance between these two. So as I have told you in the starting of this video, draw a line like this, solve from these three and this, they are in parallel. So what will be there? These three are in series, 3, 2, 3, they are in series, and just represent that. So if they are in series, then the remaining circuit will be like this, 3, this is picofarad, okay, pico means 10 to the power minus 12. So this will be in series, 3, this is point A, this is point B, and here there is again a 3 picofarad, I have just left it like that, and here there is a 2 picofarad, and here I have to find the equivalent of these three. They are in series, so how to find that? It will be 1 by 3 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 inverse. So 1 by 3 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 inverse. So it will be 2 plus 3 plus 2 inverse, or equal to 6 by 7 picofarad. Okay, so here it will be 6 by 7 picofarad. Okay, now let us again draw the next equivalent. The next equivalent will be looking like this. Now you can see that these two are in parallel. Okay, so simply add them, you will get one capacitor here, and draw the remaining part. So here A, here 3 picofarad, and here only one capacitor. Here there is 3 picofarad again, and here how much? 2 plus 6 by 7. So 6 by 7 plus 2, or it will be 20 by 7. So here you will get 20 by 7 picofarad. Okay, now again, next equivalent between these two, you can simply draw a line like this, and here there is no capacitor, so these three are in series. You can see clearly only one plates are connected, so these three are in series. So simply add them to find the net capacitance between A and B. So how much here it will be? These three are in series. Sorry, so series means you have to do it 1 by 3 plus 20 by 7 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 20 by 7, that is 7 by 20, plus again 1 by 3 inverse. Okay, or it will be, if it is 60, it will be 20 plus 3 plus 20 inverse, or equal to 60 divided by 40. Sorry, it is 21. So 60 divided by, it will be 21. So it will be 60 divided by 61 picofarad. So that is the answer. 60 divided by 61 picofarad. So this is the answer. Okay. In your exam, no need to do all the steps, but it is better to do to eliminate any error. Okay, or to reduce any kind of error. Okay. So here important thing is that to check between which two point you have to find out. And for that I have given the trick in just in the beginning of the video. You can check there how I have found the capacitance between these two points, and then I have solved. And also it is important to understand initially that you have to first find the capacitance between these two. If the capacitance between A and B is asked, you cannot start from A or you cannot start from B in this circuit. So first find out between these two points and then solve them to find the answer. Okay. Remember that here some students normally ask, sir, how to know between which two points you have to find? There is no shortcut is there. This only comes from practice. If you solve in SLORA book, you may find more than 50 or 60 amount of number of circuits. In different books, there are many more number of circuits. So practice more and more circuits to understand between which two point you have to solve, how to solve. Only I can give you the formula, but there is no shortcut, no absolute shortcut is there. Okay. And understand and remember that if you understood all these, then series and parallel connection of resistors will also be very helpful for you. But in this year particularly, in 2020, that part is not in the syllabus, but that will be useful in your entrance. Okay, this part is in syllabus, series parallel connection of capacitors. Okay, so now let us come to the next question. So this is the next question, question number 3. Here it is asked to find the equivalent capacitance between A and B. Okay, the circuit looks bigger, but it is actually a very simple circuit. How? See, if we will eliminate all these parts, all this part and this part, which are additional, looking like some additional parts are added. So first let us solve this part, or first let us remove these parts by finding the capacitance between this point and this point. Okay, if you find the equivalent capacitance between this point and this point, then obviously you don't have to join two capacitor, one here, simply find one capacitor between these two points. Okay, so first you have to find the capacitance between these two. Listen carefully and understand why I am finding between these two points. Once I am telling between these two points, to solve that is not a very big matter. Similarly, between this point and this point, I want to eliminate these three and I am to keep only one. Similarly, here I want to eliminate these two and I want to only keep one. So how to do that? Between these two points, you can see one you can come like this and once you can come like this. So why to go two times? Let us find the equivalent between these two points, so that between these two points I will only join one capacitor in place of these three. Okay, first let us solve that part, then we can do the next parts. Okay, so you can see that this is 6, this is 12, and they are in series. Okay, these two are in series. So how much that will give? 6 and 12 in series, that will give you 6 into 12 divided by 6 plus 12, or 1 plus 6, 1 by 6 plus 1 by 12 root inverse. So that will same thing here, it will be 72 divided by 18, or equal to 4. So these two will give you 4 microfarad. Okay. Now you can see that this 4 and this one, they will be in what? In parallel. Okay, let me just draw. Now I can remove these two from here. I can remove these two from here and I can add a 4 farad capacitor in place of these two. Just add a 4 microfarad. Not farad, microfarad, 4 microfarad. Now you can see that these two are in parallel. One is connected. This plate is connected with this plate. This plate is connected with this plate. So they are in parallel. So parallel means simply add 4 plus 4, 8. So now I can remove these two capacitors from here
and I can simply join a 8 microfarad capacitor between these two points. So I have joined that.
Similarly, here you can see these two are in parallel. So remove these two from here and simply join a 4 microfarad capacitor between these two points. So I have done that. Now see, the circuit looks like very simple. Okay. Now it is again very important. It is again, okay, here it is not given C, here it is let given 2 microfarad. Okay. Now again it is important to understand between which point you have to find. See, if you want to find between this point and this point, this point and this point are same because there is nothing connected. So let me just simply remove that and write the B point here. Okay. Now for finding out this between these two points, let us first find between these two points. Because you can see between these two points, you can come like this and you can also coming like this. Okay. So this point you cannot leave, means I cannot tell let us find the capacitance between these two points. Because if you find the capacitance between these two points, this B point is eliminated. That you cannot do because you have to find the capacitance between these two points. So you cannot eliminate the B point. So let us find the capacitance between these two. Okay. So between these two if we will find, then these two are in series, these two are in series, and this total and these total, they are in parallel. So accordingly you can do. So here 4 and 8 are in series. So how much they are going to give you? 4 into 8 divided by 4 plus 8, or it is 32 by 12. Okay, or you can write it as okay, let it be, or 16 by 6 you can write, or 4 it is, you can write it as 8 by 3. It is 8 4 it is 8 by 3. So you can write it as 8 by 3 microfarad. Which one? This one. In place of these two, you can write 8 by 3. Similarly, in place of these two, they are in series again. So they will give you 8 into 1 divided by 8 plus 1. So that will give you 8 by 9 microfarad. Okay. Now this one and this one, they are in series. Okay. So how much they will how much you will get between these two? You will get 8 by 3 plus 8 by 9 microfarad. This much microfarad, or that will give you, if it is 9, then it will be 27 plus 8 or equal to 35 by 9 microfarad. So what I got between this point and this point, the net capacitance is 35 by 9 microfarad. So let us eliminate all these and simply write a B point and this point and connect these two with a connection with a capacitance of 35 by 9 microfarad. Okay, so now you can remove actually all this you can remove and simply keep a B point here between this point and the B point. There is a capacitance of how much? 35 by 9 microfarad. Okay, now these two clearly seen that these two are in series. So again, the net capacitance between the point A and point B is going to be how much? 1 by 2 plus 9 by 35 inverse. 1 by 2 divided by 1 by 35 by 9 inverse, or that will give you 35 plus 18 inverse, or 70 divided by 53 microfarad. So this is the answer, 70 divided by 53 microfarad. Is it clear, the question? Okay, initially I have kept here C, correct that as 2 microfarad and you can find it. Okay, so again important to understand between which points you have to find and how to do that. Okay, first thing important, between which two point, select that wisely or correctly, then solve between these two points as I have mentioned in the initial part of the video. Okay, now let us come to the next part. So this is the next question, and this question I have just this type of question circuit I have just drawn in the initial part of the video. You can check there, and from there I can simply tell that these three are in parallel. Let me again tell you why parallel. This is connected with this, and this plate is connected with this plate. So both the plates of these are connected with both the plate of this. Now between these two, one plate is connected here and the other plate is connected here. So these two are in parallel. So between these two, one plate is connected here and the other plate is connected here. So between these two, both the plates are connected with both the plates. So between these three capacitors, they are in parallel. And this capacitor, you can see that only one plate is connected with this or with this, but the other plate is not connected with any of this. So this is in series with all the three. So the equivalent will be very simple. You can draw it like this, 2 microfarad. Here it will be 3 microfarad. There will be a 5 microfarad in parallel, and they are connected with series with a 10 microfarad. So like this. Now to solve this, you don't have to do many things, because these are in parallel. So simply add them, 3 plus 2 plus 5, so it will be 10 microfarad, and here outside there is a 10 microfarad. They are in series. So in series, I have already told, if there are two same thing, same capacitors are connected in series, then it will be simply 10 by 2, or it will be 5 microfarad. So this is the answer. So here is the difficult part, is not to identify the points, or not to identify the, or not to use the formula. Here important part is to understand that these three are in parallel, not in series. Okay. Now let us come to the next question. So this is the next question. So how the connect, this is actually a very infinite circuit, means here only one capacitor in one row, here two capacitor in one row, here four capacitor in one row, in next row it will be 8, in next row it will be 16, like that it goes on. And each capacitor, all the capacitors are of 1 microfarad. Question is, calculate the equivalent capacitance between A and B. Okay. Now how to do that? First let us draw a equivalent circuit. If I will draw equivalent, here there will be only one, so there will be no need to draw the equivalent first row. In the second row, there are two 1 microfarad in series, so they will give you 1 by 2. I have told, if n number of capacitor in series, then it will be C by n. So here two capacitors are there, so they will give you 1 by 2 microfarad. Okay. Similarly, in the next row, there are four number of capacitors, so they will give you 1 by 4 microfarad. In the next, there will be 8, so they will give you 1 by 8 microfarad. So like this, they will go on. Okay, this is the point A and this is the point B. Now all these are in parallel. Okay, so for parallel, those who do not could not understand why or how I got it, for them let me remind. I have told this while studying the series connection, that if this is C, C, C and C, like n numbers are there, n number of capacitors are there in series, then the equivalent will be how much? C by n. Okay, if all are equal. So here 1, 1, 1, 1 in series. So 1 or C by n, n is 4, so it is 1 by 4. In the next row, there will be 8, so it will be 1 by 8. So like that we have found. Okay. Now this 1, 2, 3, 4, like this, they are connected in parallel. Okay. So how much that will give you? So all these, they are going to be added. So they will give you 1 plus, or the equivalent will be like this, let it is C. Okay. And that will be equal to, this is the point A, this is the point B, and all are connected in parallel. So that will give you, C will be equal to 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8, like this.
and I think you know that this is a ZP, geometric progression. So for this you have to use the formula. What is the formula? A by 1 minus r. That is the formula, I think. Yes, A by 1 minus r for geometric progression. Sum of all the terms in ZP. That will A by 1 minus r. So here A is 1, first term, divided by 1 minus common ratio, 1 by 2 by 1, 1 by 4 by 1 by 2, like this if you will do, you will find 1 by 2. So it will be 1 by half, or it will be 1 by 1 by 2, or it will be 2 microfarad. So C will be equal to 2 microfarad. Okay. So that is the answer. And here, what does this mean? It means you remove all the capacitors from here and just connect between these two points, just connect a 2 microfarad capacitor. That will do the same thing as all these capacitors are going to. Okay, that meaning is this. Now let us come to the next question. So question number 5. Let me read out the question, you can write it down. 7 capacitors, each of capacitance 2 microfarad, are to be connected in a configuration to obtain an effective capacitance of 10 by 11 microfarad. Suggest a suitable combination to achieve the desired result. Okay, let me again read out. 7 capacitors, each of 2 microfarad, are to be connected in a configuration to obtain an effective capacitance of 10 by 11 microfarad. Suggest a suitable combination to achieve the desired result. Okay, let me tell you what is the question is all about. You are given with 7 capacitors, and you have to find the net capacitance or effective capacitance, or net I can write as 10 by 11 microfarad. And you are given with 7 capacitors, each of having capacitance of 2 microfarad. You are given with 7 number of capacitors. Okay. Now the question is, how to connect them? How to connect them means, if I am having 7 capacitors, then I mean connect something like this. 3 capacitors in series, then 4 capacitors in parallel, like this. Okay. Or I may connect 4 here, 3 here. Or I may connect 5 here, 2 here. Or I may connect 2 here, 5 here, 6 here, 7 here, 6 here, 1 here. Like that, any way I can connect them. So now the question is, how I should connect to get exactly 10 by 11 microfarad. Is the question clear to everyone? Now let us check how to solve that. So I have connected in series, let n number of capacitor. I don't know what is n. So let I am connected n number of capacitors in series, and with that I have connected some 7 minus n, because total I am having is how much? 7. So if n number I have connected here, so what are the remaining thing? Remaining will be 7 by n number capacitors in parallel, and I am telling that in this case I am getting a 10 by 11 microfarad. So you no need to draw the diagram. I have just drawn this diagram to make you understand easily. Now this n number of capacitors in series, how much they will give you? N number in series and each are equal, C, C and C, like this. For initially let me write it as C, but C value is actually 2, or let me write it initially. It is 2 microfarad, 2 microfarad, all are of 2 microfarad. Here also all are 2 microfarad. Okay. So this 2, 2, 2, 2, n number. So how much that will give you? I have already told it will be C by N or it will be 2 by N microfarad. Yes or no? So this will give you 2 by N microfarad. Similarly, here 7 minus N number of capacitors are there and N number of capacitor each of 2 microfarad. So how much you will get? 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 like this up to 7 minus N times. So how much that will give you? 7 minus N into 2. This much microfarad you will get from there. Okay. Or I can write it as simply 14 minus 2N microfarad. Okay. Now these two are connected in series. This one and this one, they are connected in series. Okay. So how much the equivalent, how to find the equivalent one will be? 1 by this much means 1 by 2 by N plus 1 by 14 minus 2N inverse. And this is given as 10 by 11 microfarad. Okay, this much microfarad, this much microfarad, I am just not writing in the unit. But because the desired one is this, 10 by 11 microfarad. So, this is the equation we got. Now, this is the equation where only one variable is there is N. So, solve it, you will get the answer. So, how to solve? Now, solve this part. Okay, this equation you can solve it. These are just some algebraic method, so I am not going to describe. You can solve and you will find N equal to 2. If some decimal number is coming or if some negative number is coming, then ignore that, because N is the number of capacitors we have taken, which cannot be negative, neither can be in decimal. So N equal to 2. What does this mean? It means that you have to connect two capacitors in series with 5 capacitors in parallel. Okay, with 5 capacitors in parallel like this, and each are of 2 microfarad, you will get this answer of 10 by 11 microfarad is the meaning. Let us, you can check that also. How? If these 5, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, it will give you 10. Okay, so this will be 10 microfarad. And here these 2 and 2 in series, they will give you 1 microfarad. Now 1 and 10 are in series, they will give you 1 by 1 plus 1 by 10 inverse, or 10 plus 1 inverse, or it equal to 10 by 11 microfarad. So you are getting that. Is it clear how to solve this type of question? If you don't know which, how many number you have to take in series, how many number you have to take in parallel, then you can solve like this. Okay. Now let us come to the next question. So this is our next question. In this question, it is given a series of capacitors where, like this, you can see. Okay, 2 microfarad are connected like this, and in between 1 microfarad are connected, and this goes up to infinite. Okay, there are a large number of capacitors are connected like this, approximate infinite number. Question is, find the capacitance between A and B. Okay, so in this type of infinite capacitors connection or in circuit, you have to check what part is repeated again and again. There must be a part which is going to repeated again and again. What is that part here? We can see this part. See, like this, it is repeated again and again and again. Okay, so first identify that part. Now, what do you mean by infinite circuit? Infinite means whatever result you will get from here. Okay, let this equivalent is C. Let this total has a result of C. Okay, or equivalence of equivalent capacitance between A and B is let C. Okay. Now, let this total is C. Now, if I will draw this total capacitance, if I am telling it as C, then I can draw it like this. There is a C capacitance between the point A and B. Okay. Now, if I will add one repeating part, what is the repeating part? This part is a repeating part. If I will add one repeating part here, means 1, 2 microfarad here and 1 microfarad here, then again I should get the same capacitance C. Why? Because that is the meaning of infinite. Infinite
plus 1 must give you the same result. Okay, it means
this shows you. Now let us just solve this circuit. These two are in series, means in parallel, so they will give you C plus 1. Now this C plus 1 and 2 are in what, in series, so that will give you how much? Let me write it here. That will give you 1 by 2 plus 1 by C plus 1 inverse, or 2 whole into C plus 1. Here you will get C plus 1 plus 2 inverse, or that will give you 2C plus 2 divided by C plus 3. Okay, so this total circuit should be how much? 2C plus 2 divided by C plus 3. But that is again given as C. Now just solve it. 2C plus 2 equal to C square plus 3C, or C square plus C minus 2 equal to 0. Now if you solve it, I can write it as C square plus 2C minus C minus 2 equal 0. If you take a C as common, it will be C plus 2 minus 1 as common, C plus 2 equal to 0, or C minus 1 into C plus 2 equal 0, or C equal 1 microfarad, or C equal minus 2 microfarad. But it is not possible, because capacitance cannot be negative, and this is the answer, C equal 1 microfarad. So this total will give you 1 microfarad. Okay, if you connect this with large number or with infinite number of these repeating parts, okay, then it total will give you 1 microfarad. That is the answer. So what we have done here we have checked what is the repeating part, and we have assumed that this total capacitance is, let C. Now if this total infinite capacitance is giving you C, means infinite plus 1, plus 1 means plus 1 repeating part, like this C plus 1 repeating part, that must also give you the same result C. That is the definition of infinite. Infinite plus 1, that will give you infinite. So C. Now the solve this circuit. Okay, if this circuit you will solve, you will find the equivalent capacitance as this. I have solved it here, and that equal to C. Now solve it, you will get the answer. Okay, so this is what is one of the tricky question, where you have to assume the answer initially and then you have to solve to find the answer. Okay, now let us come to the next question. So this is the next question, question number 7. Here the question is not about capacitance, it is asking to find the potential difference between A and B. Okay, note the question. In the circuit, find the potential difference between A and B. So in this type of question, what you have to do? Again, let us assume that at this point the potential is VA, and at this point the potential is VB. Okay, similarly, what will be the potential at this point or at this point? See, this part, potential difference means, if this part is at 12 volt, this part will be at 0. If this part will be at 13 volt, this part will be at 1 volt. Like that, potential and potential difference. So let us assume that if the battery has a potential difference of 12 volt, I can assume that this plate has a potential of 12 volt and this plate has a potential of 0 volt. Okay. Now since this plate is connected to this plate, so obviously somewhere here the potential will be again 12 volt, and somewhere here the potential will be again 12 volt, because a 12 volt battery is connected. Okay. Now since it is 0 volt, any point here it will be 0 volt, and any point here it will be again 0 volt. Okay. What does this mean? It means that potential at this point is 12, at this point is VA. So what is the potential difference across C1? It is 12 minus VA. Similarly, what is the potential difference across C2? VA minus 0. What is the potential difference across C3? 12 minus VB. What is the potential difference across C4? VB minus 0, like that. Okay, and remember the formula you are writing, C equal to Q by V, there the V is not potential, that is the potential difference. Now let us use this. So potential difference across this, potential difference across C1, or that I can write it as V1. Potential difference across C1, I can write it as V1. V1 will be how much? 12 minus VA. 12 minus VA. Okay? And okay. Here one point. Why I am not doing VA minus 12? Why I am doing 12 minus VA? Because you can clearly see that this is at higher potential and the potential gradually decreases and it became 0 here. So it is at higher, it is at lower. So better to write 12 minus VA. Okay? Now potential difference across C2, or that I can write it as V2, will be VA minus 0, minus 0 or equal to VA. Similarly, potential difference across C3, that I can write it as V3, will be 12 minus 0, sorry, 12 minus VB. Similarly, potential difference across C4, that is equal to V4 equal to VB minus 0. Or equal to VB. Okay. Now, what we are going to use is that we know that these two are in series, and for series connection, charge is going to be a constant, and we can obviously find the charge because potential we have found out and the capacitance are given. So, we can find charge. How to find charge? Q equal to C into V, this formula. Now, charge on this must be equal to charge on this because they are in series. Similarly, charge on this must be equal to charge on this because they are again in series. Okay. So, I can write Q1 equal to Q2. While writing in your copy, also write down the reason why I have written Q1 is equal to Q2. Because you can write here, because they are in series, because C1 and C2 are in series. Write those part, because now you are when you are listening me, you can understand, but when later on it is not possible to check all the videos, so better to write down here itself in the copy. Okay, so if Q1 equal to Q2, I can write it as C1 V1 equal to C2 V2, or I can write C1 is 8 microfarad into V1 is 12 minus VA equal to C2 is 4 microfarad into V2 is VA. Okay, now you can see that it is a okay, just eliminate this units, you don't know it, need it. So here it will be 96 minus 8 VA, or let me cancelling out this 2. So it is 24 minus 2 VA equal to VA, or imply that 3 VA equal to 24, or VA equal to 8 volts. So this is the answer. Potential at this point, it is potential at this point, that is 8 volt. Okay. Now similarly, you can find the between for these two type, these two. I can write C3 V3 equal to C4 V4. Remember, you cannot write C1 V1 equal to C3 V3 because they are not in series. I can write it because they are in series, or I can actually, I am writing here Q3 equal to Q4 because they are in series. So again, by putting the value here, it is 3 into V3 is 12 minus VB, C4 is 6, and here it is VB. So if you will cancel it out, you will get 2, or 12 minus VB equal to 2 VB. Or imply that 3 VB equal to 12, or VB equal to 4 volts. So this is the potential at A, potential at B. The question is potential difference between A and B. So what is the potential difference between A and B? So VAB will be equal to VA minus VB, where VA is 8 volt and it is 4 volt. So it is 8 minus 4, or I can write 4 volts. So this is the answer. Okay. So in potential difference type of question, this is the trick. You can check many questions from your books also, this type of potential difference questions. Okay. So first, the points at which the potential or potential difference is asked,
take the potential with some value Va, Vb, Vc or V1, V2 like that. Then find the potential difference across each capacitor, and if they are in series, use the formula charges are same. If they are something are in parallel, then use the formula potential are same, potential difference are same, and then you can find the answer like this. Okay, now let us come to the next question. So this is your next question, where you have to find the capacitance between A and B. This is a question where actually students get confused, but or you can solve it in different way, but I will tell you how to solve it in a very simple manner, because this question does not looks like very similar to us. So first let us make it somewhat similar or somewhat known to us how the diagram we are generally solved. So let me, this is just a wire, these are wires, so it does not mean whether the wire shape is this or the wire shape is this, this is not going to affect our result. So let me just draw this wire from here to here like this. Anyway, I have connected between these two points. Similarly, this capacitor is connected between these two points. Let us just take it out and connect this capacitor here like this. Similarly, this capacitor is connected between these two points. I can simply connect it like this also. Now we can see the circuit looks like very similar to us, and if this is a point, this is also a point, because there is no element are connected between them. Now to solve between A and B, it is a very simple question. Okay, so solve it as we are then solving, means first see, from between A point and this point you can travel like this or you can move like this also. So why to keep these two capacitors? Let us just draw one capacitor between these two points. Now you can see that these two are in what? In parallel, because you can see this is connected with this part and this is connected with this part. So these two are in parallel. So this C and C, that will give you 2C. So now between this A point and this point, A point and this point, now there is only one capacitor. So this is A point, this is this point, and the capacitance is 2C. Okay, now let us find the capacitance between this point and this point, between these two point, find as it is. So if these two are in series, these two are in series, these two in series will give you C by 2. So in place of these two, C and C and series will give you C by 2. So I can write C by 2. Now 2C and C are in series, so they will give you 2C into C by 2C plus C, or 2C square divided by 3C, or 2C by 3. Okay, so in place of these two, I can connect 2C by 3. Okay, now between these two, you can see that these two are in parallel. So simply add them to find the capacitance between this point and this point. Okay, so it will be 2C by 3 plus C by 2, because in parallel you can simply add them, or it will be 3C by 3 or equal to C. So between these two points, now I can simply draw a point here and another point here, between which the net capacitance is C. Okay, now C and C are in series, will give you C by 2. So simply in between these two points, I can write C by 2. So that is the answer. Okay, so here I have not used some new trick. Here I have just shown you that the triangle type shape, sometimes it will give you in circle type shape, those you can bring it into a general form. Like if it is given, sometimes like this, type also it will give, and it will ask what is the capacitance between A and B. It does not matter whether they are in circle or whether they will be in a straight line, because those are simply the shape of the wire, and that is not going to affect the result. So simply make it as a straight line and find the answer. Okay, or they will give you something like here,
and they will ask you what is the net capacitance between these two point.
Okay, between these two point means
obviously this and this, you have to take, you have to draw a line here. So these three in series, they will be parallel with this, and you can find the answer.
Okay, so in triangle shape, in circle shape, in any shape if they are given, it is better to take that to our familiar shape, that is a shape of a rectangle or a square, so that it will look easy. It will not make the question easy, but it will, at least it will look easy. Okay, now let us come to the next question. So this is the next question. Here it is asked to find the capacitance, net capacitance between P and Q. And what are these lines? These are actually one plate. One plate like this, one plate, one plate, one plate. So there are four plates are there. Each plate have a area of A. It is given in the question. Each plate has an area of A, and this distance is D, this distance is D. Find the net capacitance. In this type of question, first you have to see which is a capacitor, which plates form a capacitor. So let, if this side is connected with positive, so this will get a positive charge. This will also get a positive charge. Yes or no? Similarly, if this side is connected with positive, this side must be connected with negative. If this is negative, then you can see this will be negative, this will going to get negative. Okay. Now you can see this is plus minus, this is one capacitor, and this is one capacitor. Now let us see whether they are in connected in series or parallel. Two capacitor, one plate of this is connected with one plate of this, and the other plate is connected with this plate. So obviously both the plates are connected with both the capacitor, means both the plates of one capacitor is connected to both the plates of the other capacitor, means they are in parallel. So
what, and since the area and D is given, you have to write the capacitance as C equal to A into epsilon naught by D. As we know the formula, A epsilon naught by D. Similarly, this capacitance C is going to be A epsilon naught by D, and they are connected in parallel. So parallel means C net will be equal to C plus C, or equal to 2C, or imply that C net equal to 2 into A epsilon naught by D. So this is the answer, 2 into A epsilon naught by D.
So here first you have to check the charges on the plates, so that you can check which one is a which two plates forms one capacitor. Once you get that, then you can check whether they are connected in series in or in parallel by checking how many plates are connected to each other. Then just use the general formula and find the answer. And in this type of question, normally they will not give you capacitance value as 2 microfarad, 5 microfarad like that. Rather, they will give you the area of the plate and the distance between the plates, so that you can use the formula C equal to A epsilon naught by D. This I have taught you in the initial part of the capacitance chapter. So there you can check this formula and you can find the answer like this. Okay. Let us solve some one, two more this type of questions so that it will be habituated to you.
So this is question number 9, and here also these distances are D between each and every plate. The distances are D. Okay. Now the question is same. Find the capacitance between P and Q. Okay. Since if it is positive, then this plate will get positive, and this plate will get positive. See, if it is negative, then this plate will get negative, and this plate will get negative. Okay. Now what? How many number of capacitor? One this capacitor plus minus. One this capacitor plus minus, one this capacitor plus minus. There are three capacitors.
What are the difference here? You can see
here, if this is getting positive, this is getting negative, this is else again getting negative, this is getting positive. So here you can see only one pair and one pair. Between these two, this is also negative, this is also negative. So it is not a parallel plate capacitor. But here you can see this is negative and this is positive.
Okay, positive, negative, positive, negative. So you are getting actually three. One is here, one is here, one is here. Three capacitors. Now let us check whether they are connected in series or parallel.
Let us check the first and the second one. For the first one, first plate is connected here with this plate, and the second plate is common itself. So if it is common, it is common here and common here. So these two are in parallel.
Is it clear? One plate is connected to one plate, and this plate is a common between these two. Common means obviously disconnected I can take, so these two are in parallel. Now between these two, similar thing, this plate is connected with this plate and this is a common plate, so obviously these two are in parallel. And between these two, this capacitor and this capacitor, you can see one plate is connected here and one plate is connected here, so 1 and 3 they are also in parallel. So again, C, C and C, they all are connected in parallel. It is given that all of them having a having a cross sectional area of A. Okay, so the capacitance will C will be equal to again A into epsilon naught by D, and net capacitance will be 3C, 3 plus C, C plus C plus C, 3C, or equal to 3 into A epsilon naught by D. This is the C net. Is it clear what is the difference between here and here? Here in between you are getting a minus plus pair, means you are getting two plates having plus and minus charge, so it will be a capacitor. But here negative and negative, so it will not form a capacitor. That is the difference. Write down the questions actually for these two, both the question, write down the question and then accordingly you can write the answer by explaining, or don't have to explain, you can simply write plus minus, plus minus you can show and write the answer. The question is, there are four plates, each plate having an cross sectional area of A, and the distance between the plates are shown in the figure. Find the equivalent capacitance between P and Q. In both the questions, questions are same, just the diagrams are different, and accordingly you draw the diagram and find the answer. Okay, now let us come to the next and the last question in this part. See, all the questions we cannot solve. If you want more questions, then you can again go for some other books, some exercise questions, and you can find the all the questions there, and you have to practice more and more circuit to be perfect in this part. Okay, so this is the next question. Write down the question. In the diagram, each plate has an cross sectional area A, and distance between each plate with the neighboring plate is d, small d. Find the capacitance, net capacitance between the points A and B, and also find the charge on each capacitor. Okay, charge on each capacitor, and also find the total charge taken from the battery. So there are three points actually. First point, net capacitance between A and B. Second point, find the charge on each capacitor. Third point, find the net charge taken from the battery. Okay, I am just giving the hint, this is your assignment, you have to solve it. So if this is connected with positive, we can see that these three plates are connected with each other. So this will get a positive charge, this will also get a positive charge, and this will also get a positive charge. Similarly, this will get a negative, because it is connected with the negative end, this will get negative. So what are the number of capacitors here? 1, 2, 3 and 4. So there are four number of capacitors are connected here. So you have to find the net capacitance, then charge on each capacitor. Okay, this is a question, try to solve it. There are some questions in your books given using or solved using Wheaton bridge. Actually Wheaton bridge topic we will discuss in the third chapter. And while we will learn that Wheaton bridge there in third chapter, there I will tell you how to solve the circuits using Wheaton bridge. Okay, for now you can skip those Wheaton bridge questions and you can practice all the questions that I have done here or similar type of questions given in the books. Okay, so thank you, we will meet in the next class.